Okay, so as you can see, this is, you already know, you know, the Corinth Canal. And on these small vessels are, or can pass here, no? Okay, the learning outcome or learning objective is to prepare for damage reporting on the actual and possible causes of damage to the cargo and its operations. Okay, cargo damage. A cargo may be considered as damage when it is received by the buyer in a condition worse than it was dispatched by the seller. So, this is understandable, no, the definition. And you see in the background, this is Golden Gate. Okay, causes of cargo damage or damages. Mishandling of stevedores. This is the number one, no? And then, water ingress into the cargo compartment. Poor distribution of cargo weight. Condensation, inadequate ventilation, lack of clear carriage instructions, overloading, bad packaging, and contaminated floors or bulkheads, for example, paint, and others. So there are others now. These are only the more common or most common reasons or causes. Okay, what are the types of cargo damages? So we have the physical damage, wet damage, and contamination damage, and then we have another three. No? So physical damage is the cargo. Cargo is damaged due to mishandling, like dropping, breakages, being knocked during transit, and includes mishandling by stevedores. No? Sometimes the stevedores are very fast, but sometimes they commit mistakes. Especially general cargo. Na? And then for wet damage, damage caused by water ingress to the cargo compartment and includes rain leakages from pipings, entry of seawater into the holds, and others, including moisture. Na? And then we have the contamination damage. Cargo is damaged due to contamination of cargo with other cargos, or with other cargo or cargos, for example, previous cargo. Or sometimes there is a you in your cargo, there are different cargos, and maybe some cargos would also contaminate your other cargo, even grains, no? Because as I have told you, my vessel before, but I already disembarked this cape size, which is 9 cargo holds. They loaded 16 types of grains in New Orleans and then going to the Netherlands, no, in Rotterdam. So I was not there anymore. So I was not able to experience that one, no. It should be a good experience, but I have disembarked already. Okay, another damage is reefer related damage, where cargo is damaged due to reefer equipment or mishandling, because sometimes there is a your refrigeration unit also sometimes fails, no? That's why you need some maintenance also. So damage may also be physical. And then we have the infestation damage, where cargo is damaged due to infestation of course either worm or insects, no? Damage may also be contamination. And then pilferage, where the cargo or part of cargo is stolen by a person or persons. Okay, physical damage is when cargo is damaged physically or causes physical damage to other assets or property. So as you can see, there are deformations, and because this one also fell on the container, so the container is the one damaged also. Okay, causes of physical damage cargo movement during transit at sea, rolling and other vessel motion may cause damage to the cargo such as chafe. So alam niyo, you know already what is chafe, which is damage by rubbing. And because the vessel is rolling, of course, you cannot prevent this, no? Okay, but stowage is the biggest cause of physical damage resulting in damages because of improper stowage. Chafe is caused by the slight movement of packages against each other, sharp projections or rough surfaces as the ship moves to a seaway. Chafing occurs not only during heavy weather when a vessel is pitching and rolling, but under fine weather conditions when the pulsating movement and vibration of the ship is taken up by packages which may not be securely and firmly stowed on a solid floor. Even if it is strongly secured, of course, the vibration will still affect your cargo. No? Because the vibration on board is, especially if your vessel is very fast, sometimes these reefer vessels and the container vessels, sometimes they have a big or more vibrations than the bulk carrier, no? Even the bulk carrier, if it is empty, there is a lot of vibration. But if it is loaded, sometimes it is smooth. But of course, you cannot prevent vibration. Vibration is all over your vessel because of the engine and motors that are running in the engine room. Okay, chafe can similarly be caused to containerized goods by vibration and movement of vehicle on road or rail, because the containers from the vessel they can be transferred to the trucks to travel in road, and also they can be transferred to trains to travel in rail. Bailed goods, for example, textiles, skins, etc., are particularly susceptible to chafe damage. Goods shipped without the protection of packaging may be directly affected by chafe. For example, reels of cable may suffer damage to the protective insulation coating, leading to very high claims because of chafe, no? Loosely stowed cartons may rub against each other during transport and remove a thin layer of the carton surface. This may remove consignee's marks, advertisements, etc., no? Leading to a reduction in value and consequent claims. Okay, particular care must be given to the stowage of metal and plastic drums. The stow must be even and securely lashed and or tombed to prevent movement. Drum rims or lids may work against the sides of adjacent drums, and spring lids or cause punctures, resulting in a spillage with, again, a consequent claim. So some drums, they are fitted with a covering which is only spring, locked by spring, no? So sometimes this one can be easily removed. You just let open the lock, and then it will be removed. So that is not good for if these are rubbing with the other lids, no? With the other drums. But if the drum is like this, of course this is very strong, no? So this will not be removed. However, the paint will be damaged. Okay, wet damage. Wet damage, as the name suggests, is damage to cargo due to water and wet conditions. It could be related to moisture, condensation, rain, seawater ingress into the hold or container. Okay, as you know this already, this is liquefaction, no? So it is also caused by moisture, or it can also possibly caused by your leaking bilge. No, sometimes, no? sometimes your bilge is not working properly because some cargo is stuck in the valves. No, when you close it, there is still opening, and sometimes they forget to. Sometimes they use the bilge lines in the engine room, and sometimes they forget to close, or even if they use it for a long time. When they use it for a long time, then of course, if your bilge is leaking, then the water will also come inside your cargo hold. So that is the problem. That's why when loading, they must never use the bilge lines. So it should be locked. No, it should be in the engine room. No, it should be sealed, so that no one will touch it, especially grains. Okay, wet cargo. This is a container below the cargo hold, or in the cargo hold in the bottom part. Okay, causes of wet damage, moisture and condensation on board. It is usually caused due to changes in climatic conditions. Okay, moisture forms inside the hold and container due to condensation. And then another cause is water ingress. Could also happen due to holes in the hold container. Or the door or hatch cover sealing gaskets not in good working condition. Or ship's hold being flooded. Of course, flooding of the ship can be caused by some factors, including what I have explained to you, the bilge, no? If it is leaking with water. Okay, sources of moisture, the cargo itself or other cargo in the same compartment. And then packaging of the cargo. And then damage supporting or restraining the cargo. Probably it is wet or it has moisture, no? And when heated, because of the warm temperature inside the hold, it may emit moisture also, no? So the pallet or skid on which the cargo is shipped, timber sheeting, or covering, spar ceilings, etc. of the ship, or container walls and floors and floor. You have also air trapped at the time of loading or stuffing, because the air also we have the moisture. Now the air inside, which is trapped inside your cargo, also contains moisture. Okay, air introduced in the course of ventilation. Opening hatches or container doors. So even opening the hatch cover or the ventilations, no? Small ventilations, it may cause also moisture. That's why you must know when to ventilate. But I will not teach you now, maybe next meeting, on when to ventilate, because that is your activity for today. You will make a reflective essay. I have a 3-minute video there, which I did not make that one. That is made by an insurance club, so it is better than mine. No? And you will learn from them, from the video, and you must write your reflective essay based on that video, not from your research in the internet, because we have already turned it in. No, if you copy just copy in the internet, then the Turnitin will detect it. So it is better if you just watch and then put those words in your paper and then submit. There is no need to copy paste from the internet. Okay, wet damage, there are recurring issues. No, this one is from the surveyor, and they are always recurring, means always happening, always checked by the surveyors. No, which is the cause of wet damage. Of course, damaged bulbs and lines. And then leaking cargo hatch cover, combings or rubber seals in poor condition, and leaking manhole cover. So, of course, your bulbs, if your bulbs are leaking, then that is also can cause wet damage. Even the pipings, let's say there are pipings that are passing in your cargo hold, sometimes there is, no? Okay, you have also your hatch cover. We know that this already, you know, the hatch cover sometimes there are leaking because of poor maintenance. And then the same as in combings and rubber seals, no? They are in poor condition because of poor maintenance, of course. You can always rectify that. And then for leaking manhole cover, the manhole actually is or normally located in your tank top, no? Because that is the opening when you are going to inspect the double bottom tanks. That's why it is always connected to your cargo hold. That's why you during ballasting you must be careful. Be sure that your manhole inside the cargo hold are in good are tight. So there is a technique in tightening this now. Of course, you will start in one side and then go to the other side, and then you come back to this side and then go to the other side. No, you must not put it one by one like this. No, that is not the correct technique. And then for tightening, do not tighten too much on this side and then tighten on that side. No, that is not the correct. Because if you tighten on this side, probably you cannot close on the other side anymore. So that's why sometimes it is leaking. It is better to not so tight, but it is balanced, because there is a rubber packing also there, which is can be changed also if necessary. So normally our procedure is if you have the material now, if you are going to open that for a long time, then you must not return the rubber packing. That is a better practice. But if you do not have any items to replace, then you can always just clean it. You can always use that back. Just inspect that it is still thick. Okay, main areas of concern. Ignoring procedures such as risk assessment, work permits, etc. Insufficient maintenance routines for the bulbs and lines. Bilge alarms not maintained and tested properly. So our bilge, there is already an alarm, no? But if you are not testing it, so you do not know if it is working or not. And then crew ignoring bilge alarms. You just acknowledge the alarm without telling to the chief mate. Or the chief mate, he also acknowledged the alarm without checking. Of course, you need to order your AB to conduct sounding so that you will be sure that there is no leakage. Okay, location of the bilge alarm panel. Maybe it is very far from you. It should be conspicuous, you know, in the bridge. But if your bridge is very large, then it should be located in a place where you can readily see it. Lack of due diligence and adequate checks, and then insufficient experience. Now, but for insufficient experience, you can always ask your subordinates. Never be ashamed that you do not know this procedure, because sometimes they have experience that you do not know also, no? If you are a good leader, you can always ask. That means you are also a good learner, and that will be added to your experience. So contamination damage, this is next. Contamination damage is when the cargo has been made impure through pollution, poisoning, etc., which renders it unusable for human consumption or other industrial uses. Sometimes it is called tainting, and cargos which taint easily are tea flour and tobacco. This should be kept well away from strong smelling cargo. Okay, causes of contamination. Previous cargo residue can contaminate if the previous cargo used to carry some products such as chemicals or other material that can cause spoilage to the cargo. And then we have also the odor transfer. Could also be a cause of contamination due to some delicate cargo such as clothing, food products, shoes, or commodities such as coffee, tea, tobacco, cotton, etc. Next is reefer-related damage. Reefer-related or reefer cargo damage including decay, towing, freeze damage, over-ripening, bruising, off-size, and discoloration. So these are the reasons also, no? Okay, so you can see that the fruits are already deteriorated now. Okay, causes of reefer related damage. Apart from the obvious factors such as malfunctioning of reefer equipment, power failure, etc., reefer cargo damage could occur due to. So the main reason is of course malfunctioning of your refrigeration unit or the reefer equipment, no? And then another reason is power failure. But there are also other reasons, other causes, which are the following: cargo not harvested at the right time, but packed for export. So this is one reason that we cannot control, no? We cannot be blamed for this. And then improper setting of temperature, set as chilled instead of frozen, and vice versa. So this can be attributed to the crew. Because if you have committed mistake, for example, the meat, you set as chilled, and then for the fruits, you set it as frozen, then of course you will damage the cargo. And then unintentional human error, such as forgetting the minus sign before the cargo set the temperature, which makes the temperature plus. This is forgetfulness or absent-minded. Okay, another is improper stowage of the reefer cargo in the container, preventing proper air circulation. No? Of course, there is a strategy for loading in the cargo compartment, even in the container. You need to make space for air circulation. And then improper dunnaging of the cargo, which allows the cargo to move inside the container, causing crushing. And then poor quality of the packaging material use. Of course, we cannot control this also. And then contamination or taint damage, such as oil from the forklift or other machinery use. So be sure you need to check this, because this is a stevedore damage. But if you cannot see this, then it will become the ship's personnel responsibility. And then also, lack of proper pre-cooling. So sometimes the cargo needs like that, no? Just like for example us, no? Before we put a leftover food in the refrigerator, you cannot put it if it is very hot. If it is very hot, you need to pre-cool it, let it cool for a while, and then when it is already cooled, that is called pre-cooling, then you can now put in the refrigerator. So that is also applicable to your cargo, no? Some cargo needs pre-cooling. Okay, next is infestation damage. It is defined as the presence of a large number of insects or animals, like for example rodents, in a place, typically causing damage to cargo or diseases. Infestation is generally seen in the shipment of agricultural products. That's why when you are loading grain, sometimes they fumigate it in the loading port, no? For example, the voyage is only 6 days, no? But they still fumigate it. And when you go on the other port, the smell of the poison is still there, no? So during fumigation, you need to protect your the entrance or the entry of ventilation in your accommodation, because if you will inhale that for the whole night, then probably you will die for poisoning, no? Because that is a poison. So that's why they are doing this fumigation, so that to be sure that there is no infestation damage. Even rats will be dead inside the cargo hold. And in this type of vessels, you are normally supplied, when you are going to carry grains, you are normally supplied with a compressed this is only a mask, no, with compressed air. That is just like a breathing apparatus, but it is very portable, no? But that is necessary also for checking your cargo hold, because you cannot work on deck during that voyage. Okay, causes of infestation damage. Infestation in cargo could happen through transfer of pest from an infected warehouse where the cargo was stored. And then insects moving into one hold or container from other containers or cargo. And then insects present in the cargo hold or containers from a previous cargo. No? That's why it happened to us also. No? I have told you already, in Australia, they really found the infestation of insects, they found a number of insects inside the cargo, and we discovered it is in the ventilation, because the ventilation, we cannot wash it with water directly, because probably the motor will be damaged. So that's why they were there, no? The insects were there. Okay, damage due to chemical reaction. So rust damage, although considered as a physical damage, because you can see it physically, no? But actually, rust damage is a damage due to chemical reaction. As we all know in our elementary days, no, and even in high school, if you remember, but I don't remember anymore how, no, but it is of course I remember it as a chemical reaction. Okay, rust damage. Rust is corrosion of steel caused by moisture, rain water, fresh or salt, or sweat, and the presence of oxygen, producing red discoloration and, in some circumstances, heavy pitting on the steel surface. Moisture may be introduced by leakage, other cargo, packaging, green timber damage, rain on the cargo when ashore prior to loading. Sometimes they leave it on. The cargo is left. Wait. Sometimes the cargo is left open in the yard of the port. And of course, sometimes rain is will make them wet. Or also by ventilation, no? So as you can see, this is a steel coil, supposed to be black, but now there are brown colors, no? Okay, process steel may suffer irreparable damage if rust is permitted to gain a hold, while canned goods may lose much of their value to the consignee. Goods liable to damage by rust should not be stowed in the same compartment or container with cargo, packaging, or dunnage, which is liable to give off moisture. Ventilation may be a requirement, but as mentioned above, it could on occasion aggravate the situation, especially if you use the ventilation wrongly, no, in or in a wrong manner. Okay, so this is a very expensive steel coil, as you can see here. But I do not know if the inside will also become rusty, because I've never seen inside, no. But this cover will sometimes there are discoloration also. And for this cargo, this is actually a steel slab. Steel slab, no? So you cannot prevent discoloration of this. As you can see, this is already on the port, but there are already discoloration, no? So during loading, of course, you will accept that, but it depends upon the bill of lading also. And also, of course, you need to put a note during signing any paper. You need to put a note that there are already rust with the or seen in the cargo. Okay, definitions. Pilferage. Pilferage is a theft of small quantities of goods or of low value goods. Or in short, stealing a cargo, no? So this is okay. Pilferage hazard is the risk of loss to cargo when specifically covered by marine insurance through theft committed by the ship's crew, stevedores, or other having access to the insured subject matter. Okay. So I do not know which is this or who is this. Is this ship's crew or stevedore? Okay, so here I'm sure this is ship's crew, because he has very good equipment or very good gloves. So probably this is ship's crew. Huh? Okay, broach cargo. This is to open up or break a cargo such as a cask to pull out the content. That is the definition of broach cargo. Okay, this is also broach broach cargo. And then we have the jettison, the intentional throwing overboard or of part of the cargo or some piece of the ship in order to save the ship or its cargo. So that is jettison, no? Okay, container cargo damage. One of the biggest contributory causes of container cargo damage is bad stowage. So listed below are many other reasons for damage. Of course, the main reason is bad stowage, but there are other reasons also. Lack of export packaging. So we cannot control this, no? Increased use of weak retail packaging, inadequate ventilation. This one, we can control this. Wrong choice of container, that is not us. Poor condition of container, that is not us also. Lack of effective container interchange inspection, ineffective sealing arrangement, and lack of clear carriage instruction or instructions. And then ineffective internal cleaning. Of course, we are not doing that. Contaminated floors like paint, wrong temperature settings, condensation, overloading, poor distribution of cargo weight, wrong airflow settings, wrongly declared cargo, and then the bill of lading temperature notations misleading or unachievable. It means you will not understand because it is misleading or it is unachievable, meaning you cannot achieve or you cannot do this temperature or impossible to do, no? Okay, and then lack of refer points. And then also organized crime. It means this is by syndicate, no? That is considered as also as damage. Heavy containers stowed on light. Stock weight exceeded. Heat sensitive cargoes stowed on or adjacent to heated bunker tanks or in direct sunlight. Fragile cargoes stowed in areas of high motion because maybe it will be broken. Damage, worn, mixed securing equipment. Poor monitoring of temperatures because the crew are the ones monitoring this. Wrong use of temperature controls. This is due to inexperience of the crew, no?